Yeah, that's it.
And then you just want to do this one when he starts.
What's that? The PC.
I said the little green button.
Oh yeah.
When he starts.
That one.
Yeah. Yeah. When he starts. Is when you're doing that part.
You'll have to unmute his lapel mic.
Okay.
I should be back here for both of them by then. So you should be here.
Where's Cece? Douglas, where's Cece? Oh, I see her now. I see her.
Thank you. like to say it's good to see everybody here. Glad to have everybody with us. Going to our birthday this morning. We got Miss Cameron Fay. She ain't here. We'll get her tonight. But we got a Miss Melissa Rose. She's here. Anybody else have a birthday or anniversary?
Oh,
there she goes. Come on up here.
That was fingers went everywhere.
Erica had a birthday yesterday.
Who?
Erica.
Bless her heart. Come on. Anybody ever heard of
him? Harris had a birthday.
Where? She got a birthday. You didn't tell us about it. Come on, let's go.
Remember Pam, her daughter and son-in-law and granddaughter lived yesterday.
got an unspoken request, we want to let you know, but they can't. We go ahead, Brother Wayne, and Brother Tony, come on down and take up our morning talk. Go ahead, Brother Jerry, if you will, please, if you will, please.
Oh, Father, heaven, thank you, Lord, for this opportunity, Lord, you give us, Lord, to come out of your house. This morning, Lord, we just thank you, Lord, for all that you've done for us, Lord. I praise you this morning, Lord, give you glory. Lord God, we ask that you bend your ear, Lord, in this place this morning, Lord God, as there's many as God. I must pray for them, Father. I pray, Lord, that you hear the prayers this morning. God, be with each request, Lord, that's been made known. Father, I pray, God, that you bless the offering this morning, Lord, that be used, God, for your glory. Lord, for the betterment of this church and the further your kingdom. Lord, we pray for the service this morning. God, how we pray, Lord, that place one here, Lord, that would hear the message this morning, Lord, that don't know you. Maybe that's wandered away. Father, I pray, God, that you deal with them this morning. Lord, they find what they're in need of. Lord, we just thank you, Lord, for all that you do for us. You're so good to us. Lord, we're so unworthy. God, of your blessing. Lord, we need you, Father, now more than ever.
Page 116, Bible study. Thank you.
When you were about Thank you.
song says it's under the blood. If you ever remember and realize he didn't have to come do what he does. It's just a true blessing. And this song here says, I have been blessed. You heard a little about how they do it.
I'm nearly trusting.
of CP County, his wife Becky sings that song, and I appreciate that. Amen. But I've been through enough to know that he's big enough to take care of me. That's something Amen. To think about, ain't it?
Yes, sir.
All right, turn your Bibles, and we'll get right into it. You'll see, if the Lord be his helper, I hope the Lord will allow me to get to where I got in old truck. Amen. But in Exodus chapter 14, we're going to read two verses. God being our helper, and we'll go bring the message that it ain't always what it looks like. You say, well, preacher, that don't make much of a title, but that's what the Lord's given me this morning. You pray for us that we'll just get right over into the hands of the Lord, because there's a lot of folks think they know what they're looking at.
Yeah.
Amen. There's a lot of folks think they've got this thing figured out.
Yeah.
Amen. I talk to folks that's got it figured out all the time. Amen. They tell me, Granny, I'm just going to live my life, and when I die, that's going to be it. There ain't nothing else to it. But they can't see what I'm saying. Amen.
Yeah, right.
Hey, and let me tell you what the Bible says before I read my scripture. Amen. It says in 1 Corinthians chapter 13, verse number 12 and number 13, it says, for now we see through a glass darkly. Amen. But then face to face. It says, oh, now I know in part. But then shall I know even as I also I am known. And now abideth faith, hope, and charity. These three, but the greatest of these is charity. Now look at that verse. It says, for now we see through a glass darkly. There's a lot of folks think they've got it all figured out. Amen. But listen to what two verses say in Exodus 14. Amen. If you'll stand with me for the reading of the word, and then we'll get right into it. It says in chapter 14, verse number 30, it says, Thus the Lord saved Israel that day out of the hand of the Egyptians. And Israel saw the Egyptians dead upon the seashore. And Israel saw the great work which the Lord did upon the Egyptians. And the people feared the Lord and believed the Lord and his servant Moses. Let us pray. Lord, as we come to you just one more time, we thank you, Lord, for this day. We thank you for the wonderful scripture. Lord, we thank you for being able to feel your presence. God, I ask you this morning just to give us the anointing, give us the spirit of our calling. God, let us be a helper, folks. Let us be a friend, but most of all, let us be a messenger sent from heaven that we might tell folks the words that you want them to hear. I love you this morning, and I thank you so much. And Lord, we ask you to go with us. Lead, guide, and direct us in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. You can be seated. Now, when we turn to the book of Exodus, anytime you read in the book of Exodus, Exodus is a book of liberation. Amen. It is a book of departure. It means somebody is getting set free. Somebody's going to get loose. Amen. Somebody has been bound. Somebody's been afraid. Somebody's been... the devil's got somebody in captivity. Amen. And the book of Exodus, when we read this book, we are reading of them getting to being able to leave. And notice every time in the book of Exodus where somebody gets set free, it is not by the hand of man, but it's by an act of God. Amen. And if we're going to get loose this morning in our lives, it's not going to be the preacher, but it's going to be an act of God in your life. It's going to be a moving of the Holy Spirit setting you free on the inside. Amen. Now, I told you it ain't always what it looks like. Amen. You look at me, you look at the little bit of slobber I got on my face, you look at the way my eyes get big, amen. You look at the way I act, amen. Then you think there was something crazy about me. Oh, but it's old Paul looking at old Festus, and he said, oh no, Festus, he said, I'm not mad. He said, but I found out that Jesus is real and he lives in me. Amen. Hey, I want anybody here that's been set free by the grace of God, just thank him for it.
Has changed
get to the message, but I'm laying you a little point. Hey, some of us been set free. That means we've been born again. Ain't nothing wrong with that, is it? Amen. Hey, I'm getting fed up with this world that's ashamed of what they got. Amen. They are ashamed of who they are. They are ashamed of the act of it. Hey, somebody said, well, preacher, if you calm down a little bit, we can get a few more folks every time we get a few ministers. You act like a fool that's gone down, stepped on the hot coal. Amen. And done what I did. I got a hold of something that was alive one day. And that's the reason I'm here the way that I do.
Yeah.
You ever get a hold of what I got? It'll change you too. It'll change the way you think. It'll change the way you act. It'll change the way you see yourself. I'm no longer a prisoner of the devil. The devil had to let me go. But Jesus went to the center of the earth and he took away the keys to death. Say this, and I don't want to hurt no feeling. There's some of y'all, if y'all don't feel him no more than you show it, I don't know how you know he's there.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. I'm serious. I got something. Amen. He's took the chains off of me. He set my soul free. I'm free. What's like a bird in prison? I dwelt. Amen. Ain't no freedom from my soul. Oh, but he set me free. This morning.
Yes, sir.
I'm preaching, it might listen to me. It ain't always what it looks like. Amen. Listen to me. For us that's been free, that's a blessing. Amen. Hey, but then in verse 10, just build a little platform. In verse 10, listen to me. We are talking about what the children of Israel saw. Amen. And listen to me, if you that listen in the last two verses that I read to you, the tales of the great victory that they saw. But let me tell you what they saw before they ever got to see what they see. Amen. You say, preacher, what are you getting at? Well, listen, in verse 10, and listen, they had left Egypt with a great celebration. Amen. They had walked out of Egypt. Amen. Now they're to the Red Sea. And all of a sudden in verse 10, many they look back and they see there comes Pharaoh. Amen. There comes 600 chariots. There comes men after them. Amen. And I'll come to bring you some news. You didn't think the devil was going to let you go that easy, did you? Amen. There's a lot of you that, hey, listen to me, that when you got saved, you thought that's all there was to it. But the fight has just begun. Hey, listen to me. Israel looked back at the Red Sea on this side and looked behind them. Amen. And it looked like that Pharaoh was fixing to overtake them. Amen. Oh, can you imagine the dust storm that they must have seen in the back of them? And they realized in their minds, Pharaoh's done got mad. Hallelujah, we done made the devil mad. But somebody ought to take him over in the book of John and quote him a little scripture and tell him, greater is he that is in me than he that is in the world. And then we ought to let him know. Hey, it ain't always what it looks like. Right now, Israel's looking up there and they're seeing that dust bowl and they know Pharaoh's coming and they're looking to the left and they're looking to the right. They're looking straight ahead. Hey, some Christians in the house today that don't know which way to go. Amen. And it looks like God has led you to a place in your life that where the devil's going to devour you. It looks like in your life that God has led you to a place that where the devil's going to get the best of you. Oh, but James said, don't run. Amen. He said, submit yourself unto God and resist the devil and he'll flee from you. Amen. This is your day. I'm going to tell you something today. Hey, listen to me. You know what they saw in verse 10? They saw the devil on their heel. I'm going to tell you something today, Christian. The devil's after you more today than he ever has before. He knows he ain't got but a few days to work. And he's trying to devour everybody he can. He's trying to devour them. He's tried to deceive them. He's tried to defeat them. He's tried to destroy them. He's tried to get rid of them. Amen. But I'm going to tell you what, it ain't always what it looks like. Hey, over there on the Red Sea, it looked like that the devil had the upper hand. Oh, listen to me. I found out something. Amen. That was very fascinating when I was studying. You know what? It wasn't the mission being a slave that left Egypt that Pharaoh was after. Amen. But it's after. You know what he was after? Amen. It's what they left with. Amen. Oh, somebody get a hold to them. You know, Pharaoh to get more slaves. Amen. Oh, but you know what the children of Israel left with? They left with the treasure of Egypt. Amen. They left with the gold. They left with the silver. Why, when they left, they were blessed so much they were having to tote it on their back. Amen. Oh, somebody get a hold to them. Pharaoh was after that treasure that couldn't be replaced. You know what? The devil ain't after you. He's after what you got. He's after that joy. And he's after that peace. He's after that happiness that you got down on the inside. And that's all Pharaoh would want. If he could get it back, he'd go get him some more slaves. But he never could replace the treasure. I'm so glad I got a treasure. That's irreplaceable.
We've seen
We've seen the children of Israel. They've left, and now they have seen the devil is on their tail, on the trail. Excuse me. I didn't mean to say that word. Amen. Some of y'all didn't get that. Some of y'all did. Amen. But listen to me. They are got down there, and all of a sudden they see the devil coming. I want to tell you, I wanted to stop and tell you, Brother Larry, now that you quit doing the things that you used to do, does not mean that the devil's not going to come back after you and tempt you to do it again. Why, you might be going through a trying moment right now in your life, and the devil's trying to tempt you. Well, one of them colds sure would be good. Oh, just do something that you used to do to give you a little peace of mind. I ain't picking on Brother Larry. There's a bunch of y'all get tempted. Some of y'all need to realize the devil ain't going to leave you alone. The only time he leaves you alone is when he's got you. Amen. Hey, but Brother Donnie, the devil's always on our trail, and he's always tempting us, and he's pushing us, and he's trying. Listen to me. Can I talk a little strategy? Can me and you talk a little strategy that I know the devil did? I can see the devil in hell, and he looked at his reality. He knows the Bible. He knows the right to the promised land. Listen to me now. And he promised he's very smart, and he's got a real good mind for military things. He knows when to attack. He knows where to jump you at. He's good at ambushing you. Amen. He probably looked at a few of them little demons, and he said, wait a minute. When they leave Egypt, I know the way that God's going to go. I'm going to preach this morning. Amen. It ain't always on what it looks like. Amen. You say, preacher, what do you get at? I can hear the devil say it. Listen to me. They're going to come to a point. God's not going to take them the short route. Oh, but he's going to take them around. He ain't going by the Red Sea. He said, I tell you what we'll do. I said, we'll stay right here and we'll jump them. By the time they get to where they don't think there's nowhere else they can go, amen, we'll just get a hold to them right there. So the devil got a plan. Amen. You don't think in all them 2 million Jews they wasn't some little demons running around?
Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, you see it. Amen. Listen to me. I love cowboys. Amen. I watch all westerns, and when they got a man they want to lynch in the jailhouse, the one that wants to do the lynching, he's usually not the loudest one. You know what he usually does? He'll go around and give you 2 or 3 stooges and get them all fired up. Amen. I don't want to be a devil stooge. Amen. I don't want to go around causing trouble. But these boys on the cowboy, the devil, they'll get these stooges fired up, and they'll tell them that man needs to hang. Amen. That man needs to be strung up. And then they'll start igniting the other. I can see the people, little demons in the Jews over there. Oh, we're dead. We ain't got nowhere to go. God has left us. Amen.
Yeah.
Come
on, bless the Lord. Come on.
Amen. Let me tell you what spreads around churches. Amen. Let me tell you. You know who I listen to. It don't take but a few little demons, amen, to go around saying, you know, singing dead over there. You know, they don't do nothing no more. But Mike, let me tell you, that's what the devil does. He plants folks in your church. Amen. Now don't nobody look around. I ain't pulling nobody's name. Ain't gonna point nobody out. But Miss Kendra, they could be one next Sunday walk in and sit beside you. And this is what he can tell you. And I love you with all my heart, but things ain't always what they look like. He can tell you, Miss Kendra, God took your mama. He took her away from you at an early age. She was only 58. And he didn't let you have her. And he's trying to make you upset. But Miss Kendra, let me preach to you this morning. Things ain't always what they didn't look like. God didn't take her away from you, but God helped you. He helped you that your mama wouldn't have to suffer no more. He took your mama to a better place. He said, we ain't going to send that preacher back up to that river no more. They were something it wasn't a cold water. But all week long, God's been dealing with me on this. He said, tell your church, it ain't always what it looks like. Amen. Somebody said the little church is dying away. Amen. It ain't always what it looks like. There ain't but one church. And Jesus said, upon this rock I'll build my church. Somebody said, preacher, I know how they feel. I'm right there at the Red Sea in my life. Well, let me tell you just a few things that the devil wants you to think. He wants you to think that you have no hope. Amen. Listen to me. And if we took time in the 11th and 12th verses of that 14th chapter, Miss Petey, you will find that where panic is spreading among the Jews, all of a sudden they're telling each other, they were just rejoicing the other day. Amen. But now panic has spread because somebody said, we're hopeless. Amen.
Come on.
Boy, you let that go around. You know what they're doing? What is hope? The Bible says faith is the substance of things hoped for and the evidence. So when I look at hope, I look at having faith. And you know what's happening to the children of Israel? They are beginning to lose their faith in God. A God that was able to cripple the greatest power on the earth at the time that they were in bondage. You take your history book, there was no greater power than Egypt was. There was no greater man than Pharaoh. Brother Tony, he was the man of the hour, but he met the God of the day. Amen. Oh, he found out what God was all about. Well, listen to me. All of a sudden, they begin to doubt. They begin to lose faith. And that's what some of you are doing today. I preach to our young folks, and I preach to our kids. Don't you give up on God. Don't you walk away from God. I don't care if you have to stay by yourself till you're 55. Amen. I don't care. The only person you got in your life is a German shepherd. Amen. I want you to trust God, and that's all you need, and believe that God knows what's best for you in your life. I know this imagine that my style is the old style. And I preach on keeping yourself clean from the sins of the world. Come ye out of the world and let me do what God said. And God will bless you tonight. Amen. But the devil preaches, God's a God of love. You just do whatever you want to. He'll forgive you. But God's also a God that chastises those that he loves and those that he don't chastise. Our master and not a son. Amen. I'm just not worried, but I'm preaching the truth this morning.
Amen.
Ain't always what it looks like. When God don't like me, or I wouldn't be alone. God's getting you ready so you don't have to be alone. Hey, let me tell you, I'm gonna preach to everybody, amen. Hey, I got looked in these eyes. There is no fear either. Not this morning. I'm that slight praise of happy man. Amen. You see me? Amen. I don't care. Hey, listen, there's a time in a man's life where God will take over and he loses all fear, Brother Mike, of what people think about him. Hey, I got folks in this church that need to realize, amen, if you can't get your boyfriend in church now, don't expect to get him in once you get married. Amen.
Amen.
I'm going to go ahead and preach the way God said. I'm not worried about you getting him in. I'm worried about him dragging you out.
That's right. Amen.
That's the reason they don't want to talk to the preacher. That's the reason they don't want to meet with me. That's the reason they don't want nothing to do. Because I'm going to get them. I'm going to tell them that little girl belongs to this church. I'm her under shepherd. And if you can't bring her to church now, I think you just ought to leave her alone.
That's right.
Bring your dad with you when you come. Bring your mama with you when you come. I'll talk to them too.
Yes, sir.
It ain't crazy. But things ain't always what it looked like. I ain't got time to go over everything that's going through my mind. But I'm going to tell you what. Israel has lost hope. Listen to me. They think, number two, they think they're at a dead end. How many of y'all Christians think God has led you to a dead end? God didn't lead you to a dead end. He's got a brand new opening. He told you about his life. I got a new life for you. He said, I got a new life for you. I'm going to tell you something. Granny, I have worried for 5 years about folks coming to this church. But you know what God charged me this morning? He said, I don't care if it gets down to Zach, Petey, amen, and a few more, amen. He said, you tell them like it is. You tell them how wise they expected of them. And then if they can't handle it, they can go find them something else. Amen. We've got too many men of God preaching with scared that's in their life. Scared that folks are going to leave them. I got one that said he'd never leave me, never forsake me. He'd be with me all the way until the end. He told the disciples in the 28th chapter of that Ooh, if they ever felt it, I'm telling you right now, God wants folks to know it ain't always what it looks like.
Hey, let me get back up here. I'm worried with folks. Can I help you, God? I just had an inspiring thought, and I don't know why it came on my mind. Some of y'all already swelling up. Some of y'all said, you can't talk about my boyfriend like that. If it wasn't the truth, what you worried about? Anybody want to come back?
Yes, sir.
If it wasn't the truth, what you worried about? Hey, amen. I'm being serious. How can folks go everywhere else, but they can't find it to come to the house of God? You looking through a glass darkly, hon. Amen. You better quit looking at John Tom that said through them rose-colored glasses. That man's got to get what he can get. You better tell him this ain't of God or nothing at all. Amen. How'd I ever get you? Amen. They think I was a devil, but I meant to probably. How'd that woman ever get hooked up with a wild man like that? You can't help what God does. She can't help who she has to love. Now, she can't help who she has to live with. God said, if you won't be happy, that's the fool you got to be with right there. Amen. That's who you got to live with if you want to find peace. I'm so glad God had her. Amen. And I said that to save the idea. I said that to say this. Some of you are sitting back there trying to make your own decision, trying to find the one that don't come. You don't do it by looks. You don't do it by weight. You don't do it. Hey, I just want to do it by God sent. Whoever God sends into my life, that's who I want to be there. Because of the word came out.
Amen.
I've been alone so long. You don't know what I've been going through. Amen, but God does. You don't, do you, have you been in this way long enough to know that God knows what's best for you?
Yeah.
Do you hear the song that was sung this morning? The little lady said, I've been in this way long enough to know that God knows what's best for me.
Yeah.
I'm preaching to keep folks out of trouble. Amen. You know what? I found folks don't want to talk to me when they ain't living right.
That's right.
Amen. They don't see me come. I'm worse than a mailman, baby, with beans. Amen. They see me pull in the yard, they lock the door. Amen. They shut the window. Slap the yard. Don't you make a sound. That's that crazy preacher from over there in Trinity. Gonna want to know where me and your daddy's been. You tell him we had somewhere to go. Come give me an excuse. Amen. I'm preaching this morning. Things ain't always what it looked like. Amen. To the children of Israel, they saw no hope. They saw a dead end. And I can understand it. Amen, Brother Jeremy. I'm not trying to be a smart ass preacher, but I'm going to tell you what. I can understand how the children of Israel might have thought that. They listen to me. They've never, as far as I know, in a long time, been down to the Red Sea. You understand what I'm talking about? They've been in bondage. They've been on the, they ain't walked like free men long. Right. Amen. There's some of y'all ain't learned to walk upright yet.
Right.
Oh, look out, preacher. Yeah. Amen. Can I show you how some of y'all still walking? The devil had you bound by alcohol, had you bound by drugs, had you bound by folks that hung around you, and you walk around like this. Tied up and everything in the world. Oh, but Jesus come back and he set you free.
Yeah.
And he let you straighten up. And some of y'all still walk around like that. Some of y'all still walk around like y'all now. The Bible said if the Son sets you free, you're free again. John, hey, that's what he said. Some of you need to learn to walk upright. Well, preacher, if I walk up right, I have to look at what's in front of me. It's about time.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. That's right.
You know the reason a lot of folks walk like this? Because they don't want to look and see what's in front of them. And I'm tired of this pitiful situation in your life. I'm my only child. You don't know what my mama did and done to me. You don't know how I've been treated. God does. Every bit of it. He bring you out of that. I tell you, I know God gets taught here.
Yes, sir.
Amen. He sets you free. He's giving you your life, your choice, your... And I'm telling you what, He said, I want to bless you. Jesus said the devil has come to steal and kill and destroy. He said, but I come that you might have life and have it more abundantly. Amen.
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 I got to go. I got to please these right here. Amen. And he said, it looked like what the Israel first saw was no hope, dead end. And this is what God told me of this. And all of a sudden they saw it, and they thought in their heart that they had a God that didn't know what he was doing. Amen. And some of y'all getting led down to the banks, and all of a sudden you're beginning to doubt that God knows what he's doing in your life. I tell you what, some of you rather trust in yourself. Hey, I know there's some folks in our church that say, why did I come today? Why did I come today, Lord? I should have come another Sunday. Amen. Amen. I should have picked me another. Why, God would have saved this for you. Amen. You that one walking around like you're still bound, you ought to walk around like a free man.
Amen.
Amen. Walk around doing this instead of doing this.
That's right.
They have come to the point where now they are doubting that God knows what he's doing. And when you doubt God, you doubt his capabilities.
Right.
You doubt that God is able to do what he said he would. Amen. God said they could have problems and he's going to take them to them. Now all of a sudden the devil's got a doubt. Three things that they are, all that they have seen. Now there's a lot more, but I know that you're tired and we're fixing to go. Amen. But listen to me. Brother Larry, they have saw. They are looking over there. And they don't see, the picture is, can you see all them folks along that bank of that river? Now this is what I want to tell you. Skeptics have said that they did not cross the Red Sea in the deepest part. Skeptics say that they went to a shallow part and in the dry season that it was dried up and they walked through there. Okay. Let's go along with the skeptics, okay? Let's go along. Hey, some of y'all smart folks that's already got this thing figured out. Let's go along with that. Let's go along that God led them to a shallow part. Let's go along to where it wasn't much of a miracle that he led them across on dry ground. Amen. Somebody please tell me how God drowned 600 chariots and 600 men in knee-deep water.
That's right.
Amen. Yeah. Somebody help me preach this morning.
Yeah.
Somebody help me. It would have been a greater miracle to defeat one of the greatest armies that there ever was in ankle-deep. Well, wait a minute. Y'all said it was dry ground. How did he drown them in dry ground? I'm waiting. Amen. Somebody help me because would have been a greater miracle, amen.
That's right.
How about that, devil? Amen. How do you call that, devil? Well, listen, I got to hear that. God's given me this message for somebody, and I know I act like a smart aleck. I know sometimes I come over, I'm too overzealous, amen. I get too enthused. But Zach, God's done something. See, folks don't know where I was. They don't know what bondage I was in. They don't know how the devil had your baby. You don't know. Amen. It was before your time. They don't know how I was tied down. They don't know what it feels like to be free like me. Amen. They don't know that. Oh, glory. Amen. They don't know how it feels to be able to walk upright. Not to be ashamed of where you go. Amen. They don't know what it feels like.
That's right.
Oh, yeah. Listen to me. Where was I? Great miracle. Let me tell you what. Let me show you the blessing. See, I had a good time. Do you know what? If I'd have been one of them Jews standing on the banks of the Red Sea, and all God would have done was took it down to the shoe tops, I would have been happy. I would have been happy, Randy. I'd have been happy the way we lost it. Wouldn't you, God? With 600 chariots behind you, wouldn't you be satisfied just to wait out there? I know you don't like the water. Me and you to wait it on out there. You too, you don't like it either. Oh, now listen to what the preacher said. I'm making the point. I would have waited on, that would have been sufficient.
Yeah.
I would have put old Zach on my back if he'd been a little.
Yeah.
Walked on the cross. Amen. Listen to me, Doug. That would have been good enough. I would have praised him for that. I would have praised him for that. I would have praised him for water being wasted. He let me get through it. But that ain't all he done.
The Bible said that he blew that wind and he dried the ground so that I didn't get my feet wet. Amen. When I walked through, he didn't have to, somebody say. Oh, but he did. Amen. He didn't have to. Oh, he didn't have to die. But he did. Amen. That's how good God is to us. You ever thought about that? Well, lady, I'm going to be like, I know me and you. We step to say, the biggest problem Moses would have had once he had got to where Zach got to have his head above water was saying, wait a minute. Now, why are you saying this? I'll go ahead and tell you. Because there's a few of y'all want to jump ahead of God.
That's
right. See, old Zach's like he did. He's just entirely, whoo, whoo, he goes, you know. Amen. Listen to me. Those that wait upon the Lord shall renew them. But to those that waited till Moses said, okay, let's go. They didn't get wet. They were some Jews that had to endure the wetness because they might have jumped in before time.
Yep.
Some of you are wanting to get ahead of God. Some of y'all want to put God's car before the horse. You know what happens? Things stop. I got to hurry. That's what it looked like. Now, due to the evidence that we have before us, it does seem evident that God has made a mistake. Is it not right? Now, I'm not Perry Mason, but if I would have been the prosecuting attorney, I would have said, Your Honor, due to the evidence that we have before God, he has led his children to a bank of the Red Sea that they can't get across. He has allowed the devil to trap them down to the bank. And he has given them by no certain terms what he's going to do next.
Right.
Your Honor, it sounds like a God that has failed. And that's what it looks like. But hold on. Things ain't always what it looks like.
Right.
Things ain't. Oh, somebody get up. Somebody said it's another 30 minutes. No, I ain't going to make it. Oh, I can preach this morning. I'm liberated this morning. Amen. I might not ever get to preach a lick again. But this morning, you had to bless your sweetheart. I know what it feels like to feel the power of God in your life and to be able not to fear what nobody thinks or what nobody cares. Brother Mike, I know what it feels like to let God know that you're on the right track. Amen.
Amen.
So, I wish I'd known that man. Hey, what's that? The prosecuting attorney for Perry Mason. Burger or something. Amen. Amen. He never did with a cash. He might be a devil. Devil ain't never beat God. No matter what it looks like, the devil might have had an upper hand, but he's never won.
Amen.
Things ain't always what they look like. Now we have delivered the prosecuting attorney. We'll have to sit down now. Just have a seat. Just sit down. You spoke your piece and did the judge would look at the defense attorney and says the defense ready to present their case. I can see the Holy Ghost getting up, can't y'all? Your Honor, I know that they are some intimidating circumstances here. And I know, Your Honor, that it does look bad for the defendant. But Your Honor, we would like to state our case.
Yes, sir.
We would love, oh, can somebody help me this morning? Amen. Can, but Your Honor, can things ain't always what they look like, Your Honor. Your Honor, oh, somebody, I can see the Holy Ghost now. Amen. Your Honor, I have got some evidence.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
Bless Your Honor.
That God did not leave them there by themselves.
That's right.
Boy, about the 15th chapter, Moses said, stand still.
Yeah.
Said, stand still. See, Your Honor, God sent them word. Amen. He did not leave them there without a word. I'm so glad that we have the word of God and that when the world's on fire, that this is going to stand. God told him to stand still and see the salvation of the Lord. Moses said, fear not. He said, this Pharaoh, this devil that's been chasing you, this devil that's been after you, he said, God's going to defeat you. He said, after the day, you ain't going to see him anymore.
That's right.
I got news for you Bible scholars. Y'all look at Pharaoh, he ain't mentioned much no more. Not chasing the children of Israel no more.
Amen. That's all right. Don't get excited. I know. I know. Listen to me. It's getting that happy hour. We're both ready to go. Listen. You are. We had a man in the sea. His name was Moses. I know, Mom, Your Honor, that he got a little shaky at times. God told him to raise his arm.
Yeah.
But when it didn't look like there was no hope, he said, Your Honor, there was a big wind. I said, God, just breathe. Yeah. You ever been sitting in church and just feel something for the Lord?
Yeah. Yeah.
Woo. Now, you know what? Y'all ever felt that? I mean, you know what that's liberating. Amen. Y'all say, well, quit learning a new word. Yeah, I think it's time some of y'all learn, but y'all act like y'all still locked up. I don't know what it is that binds some of y'all. I don't know what it is. Miss Sherry, can I talk about you? I love Miss Sherry. I almost took her head off one day, but not being mean, I feel bad because I like to pull away. We jumped off a raft. Now, none of the other women got out of our boats. And I was the only one guy to jump off of. But when I got back here and I looked at the ship, I said, you won't do that, didn't you, the ship? I said, you won't jump off that raft, didn't you? I said, you won't do that, didn't you? She said, she called me. And she said, yeah, preacher, I did. She won't. But you know what? It wasn't fear that kept her in the boat. It was what people would think about her that kept her in the boat. It wasn't her getting hurt or having to come home and explain to Donnie why she broke her leg. That didn't hurt anybody. Amen. But Brother Tony, she was afraid of what folks would think about her when she climbed up. I got used to, there's a lot of y'all bad hungry on what y'all think people going to think about y'all. They'll think I'm a lunatic. It don't matter. Amen. Can I tell you what? We had a good time yesterday. Amen. Amen. And you know what, folks can call me the slobber, the spit, this amen, the craziest prayer. But I enjoy what I do. Won't you try to explain to me what you do?
Right. Yeah,
there you go.
Yeah.
I got to go. Say this. Some of these folks, when I've been here long enough, know we go out to eat. My table manners are just, Pete says, just don't hit Larry or Jeremy or or somebody with your elbows when you lay down. Now, when I eat and I like it, I go,
Yeah.
And you know what? I'm not being funny, but I enjoy eating just like I do church. You said, I love you, Mark, but it don't matter if you sit right up under me, I'm still going, You see what I'm saying? What's bound you this morning that you can't act like a free man? The Holy Ghost said, Your Honor, I know there are some circumstances that look intimidating, but can I just give you the end of it all? To make this short, I know the jury's going to deliberate with me. Your Honor, I'd just like to go to the end of the matter. I'd like to bring in some folks. I'd like to bring in some folks that might testify on his behalf. One little Jew walks in. Son, can you tell me what happened? In the ninth chapter of the book of John, that little blind boy says, I don't know whether he be a sinner or not. I don't know what you want to call him.
Right.
He said, like, Your Honor, all I know, I was blind. I couldn't see no way out. I couldn't see which way to go. I had to be led. But Your Honor, all I know is now that he spit up on some clay and he anointed my eyes and he told me to go to water. And now I see. Now what are you doing? And the Jew said, Your Honor, I don't know what to tell you. We was at the Red Sea. I seen Moses stretch forth his hand. I seen the water begin to move. I seen things begin to happen. He said, before you know it, I was walking across. What do you have? He said, Your Honor, I am here today by the grace of God. But I have nothing to have done. But because God was so good to me. We're going to blend the song. We're going to play that song again. Get your ready, Shane. I know you're ready. There's some of you
things don't look good in your life right now. Things ain't always what it looks like. Preacher, God love me. And I know you probably think I get into your family business too much, but your girls, and I consider Allison you one of his girls. Listen, I got an outstanding I got that right. I mean, so I worry about them.
Yes, sir.
Now, see, the devil's after them. See, I got some older ladies in the church. They've been in the way long enough to know they can trust God.
Yeah.
Amen? Amen.
Right? Yeah. Yeah.
Right. Come on now.
That's right.
Let's do this. Gently, all the men, be quiet. If I got any ladies in the church that know they can trust God,
yeah.
You be quiet, man. I got any more ladies in the church that know they can trust God?
Amen.
Say it out loud.
Amen.
Thank y'all. I know you think I'm overpowered, and I know you think I put folks in the spot. They, some folks ain't never going to get out of the boat pen on somebody to push a little bit.
Mama.
Push just a little bit. Just give me a little. I want to do it, preacher. Just give me a little push. Amen. We're not going to shove you out over. At this point, we want you to push you over to the hands of God. And you stand there and trust God with your life. Somebody said, preacher, I don't want nothing to do with you or your God. That's okay. And we still won't be mad at you. You can come anytime you want to. Those that trust God know that He is a God that is able. Can I show you something tonight? I want to tell you something, folks. God is so good. There's no way I can figure this out, what He wanted this morning. But He was so good that He allowed me just a little bit just to feel His presence and understand His word. There's folks in our church that thank God don't know what He's doing in their life. They thank that God does not know. See, just because you can't see where you're going, don't mean that God can't. Just because you don't think God's made it. Alright, we're going to say this, we're going to say it. Got me one of them navigation things mentioned in my truck. They tell you how I am. That little woman come on there and she said, take a left. Turn a left. I say, you're stupid. I'm going straight. I know a shortcut. y'all ever talk to it like that?
Yeah.
She'll say, go up there and make a U-turn. That means you went the wrong way. Turn around, bro, come back. Huh? You know what I say? She don't know where she's going. And all of a sudden, I hear a little voice in the back. Diddy, why don't you just turn the thing off if you ain't going to listen to it? You got a good point. Why do all the theatrical things if you're not going to listen to God?
Right.
Why put on the show if you ain't going to trust Him? Why act like if you ain't going to follow? Why even talk about if you ain't going to believe? This morning, God's visited with us, not because of me, but because of you being with us. And He wants you to understand something this morning. I have not led you this far to leave you. I have not led you this far to walk away from you. There, some of you have not sold out. Some of you are like the Israelites in Europe. You have seen the devil. He's come after you. And you're on the verge of going back to Egypt. I wish that I had time to preach that. How many have left the banks and went back to Egypt? Not for a good life. Not for a good life. But they went back to be slaves. They went back to bondage. They went back to die in the field. I ain't made to die in the field. I'm headed home. I'm like that prodigal son. When I get there, I'm going to tell you, Father, I'm no longer worthy to be called your son. Just let me get there. Help you this morning. You're on the verge of going back to Egypt because you don't believe that God knows what He's doing. Young folks have the capability now. I know we have a different breed of young folks today. They're not like us. Because see, when we were growing up, we thought we knew everything.
Yeah.
We thought, when I was a kid, I didn't think nobody could tell me nothing. I know we don't got kids like that nowadays. Amen. Go to Africa. But you know what? The old preacher's here to tell you, don't you leave from where you got. You've got this part. You're at the cross, and God is fixing to provide the waters in your life. And He is fixing to let you go out through with dry ground. But you listen to that. I don't care how much dust you see behind you. I don't care what you see back there. I don't care what he looks like. I don't care what he's got. I don't care how much money. You just keep walking forward. Waiting on the Lord. While we stand, I'm on us. All right, Shane. We're going to play this song. Will you trust him enough to let him be enough for you in your life?
Come on. the Lord in prayer. Lord, as we come to you just one more time, we thank you, Lord, for this day. We thank you for the good spirit, the good singing. Lord, we thank you for your presence in our congregation this morning. We pray that you have touched hearts that are real close. God, you're going back to Egypt. God, you have touched hearts that have sought. You just don't let that think that you don't know what you're doing. But God, we are so glad today that we are in your hands. And we do know that the steps of a good man are ordered by the Lord. And God, we thank you for it. God, no matter what our life holds, God, you know, the Lord, what we can handle and what we can't handle. God, I pray that you would just watch over. God, not putting him above nobody else. God, but I pray this week, God, that you would ride that old black truck. We'll put an angel around him. God, just keep him safe. God, not just him, but every person, every one of these kids. I pray that you'd be with them. Watch over them. Take care of them. I love you, Lord, and I thank you for being on my side. Lord, as the scripture said in Psalms, what would I have done if it had not been for God being on my side? I love you this morning. Go with us, lead, guide, and direct. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. I want to make an announcement before I forget it. Tonight we will be having a special conference. We've got to get you voted in so we can get our air conditioning heating system put in. So we'll be running that through conference tonight. So if you're a member, you can be here with us. Amen. And I'm sure God bless you. Amen. Remember that. Remember choir practice at 4:30. And I want to bring this up. This is youth choir practice. And I want to ask all my youth, everybody that sings in the youth choir, I want to, Wednesday night, we're going to UK and we're going over there to sing. I want you to come and I want you to sing just like you sung this morning. Just like you sung this morning is how I want you to sing when you get there. With the same spirit, with the same power, and the same attitude that you had this morning. Just let me sing to God.
Yes, sir.
Okay?
Yes, sir.
Amen. Now, I do have y'all's addresses, and if y'all are not here by 6:30, I will be coming to you. No, I'm kidding. I'm actually got real words. She said, no, I'm kidding. Now, let me tell you other folks something. This does not give us a night off.
That's right. That's right.
They need our bag. So everybody that will, come be with us, go with us, and let's go help Brother Mike Soup over there. He came that means tonight at their revival right there. And I'm sure the Lord bless you. Please, let's come and let's make a good show in the church right there. So remember that. All right. Any other note?
Just remember that August the 8th will be free water day. The youth is going to be hosting the window at the Auburn yard sale, community yard sale, be uptown. So anyone that will, bring your water on in, and that'll be starting. I think right here, the Central Trust is set up around somewhere around 7 and 4 o'clock. The yard sale is part of me. So it's the first time, first serve on the spots. So anyone wants to help with that?
All right. You got that? Any other announcements before we go? How many love the Lord?
Amen.
How many believe it ain't always what it looks like?
Amen.
Amen. I love you this morning. Nothing else? Stand to your feet. Turn around, shake hands with one another. Consider yourself dismissed.